We arrived at the Pacolet River Heritage Preserve on a warm, sunny morning. The trail looked shady and cool, but we knew we had a hilly hike ahead of us. So we grabbed some water and ambled off into the mixed hardwoods here at the gate. It quickly became obvious that we would be taking turns leading. You only have to walk into a few of these webmasters to appreciate the joy of a slow and alert stroll. It was a little late for most plants to be blooming, but we did find a few, including this tiny marsh pink, along with a daisy fleabane. A few steps away was this wild petunia, with some apparently tasty leaves for the local insect population. What really captured our interest was this small patch of river oats. We expected to see them, but certainly not this high and dry, almost 90 feet above the river. This must be a good spot, though, because a quick inventory of trees right there yielded ash, pine, poplar, oak, and maple, all doing quite well side by side. And just to set itself apart, this redbud was situated just ahead, casting shade from its heart-shaped leaves onto the trail and onto this rotten log, hosting a small yellow mushroom. This hickory tree overhead was also providing a fair amount of shade on the trail, along with more than a few nuts that came crashing down during the last fruiting season. The trail begins to drop toward the river a little more now, and we graciously greet the few creatures our noisy arrival hasn't scared away. This patch of pussy toes was getting a thorough exploration by a red ant. It also made a good launching pad for this spider, and we hoped he wasn't on his way to weave a web across the trail for us. A little closer to eye level, these caterpillars were busy doing whatever caterpillars do until they're ready to leave their silky high-rise and travel their small world. Looking ahead, we start to notice rocks alongside the trail. Geologically, the Piedmont of South Carolina is composed of metamorphic rocks, so the occasional vein or outcrop is the result of great heat, pressure, and chemical influences over the millennia. This maple with its bowl-shaped hollow served as a landmark for a big downhill. The river can be heard through the forest now, and the trail appropriately descends into the floodplain. We clamber down and cross the first of two bridges along the route. This one crosses a small creek that feeds into the Pacolet River a few dozen yards downstream. We also begin to see the primary reason that this area needed protection: soapstone. Pacolet River Heritage Preserve covers 257 acres and includes a couple of soapstone quarries used by Native Americans during the Archaic period. This was a time when early man began to live more often in communities and depend on the local resources. Soapstone is soft, easily carved, and can withstand rapid heating and cooling. This trait made it useful for many things, especially cooking. It was later used for pipes and pendants. Interestingly, these quarries show no signs of habitation, hunting, or plant collecting activities, so it is likely they were used only as a source for soapstone. Discoveries of soapstone objects outside the southeastern areas where it occurs naturally are an indication of its value as a trade item as well. Moving on, the floodplain offered a chorus of songbirds that couldn't be heard in the upland portion. Even though we never saw them, Carolina wrens were definitely in the canopy overhead, just singing their hearts out. We followed the trail markers along the now narrow trail with an edge of thick green grass. The moisture in the soil also nourishes other water-loving plants here, like this birch tree and its distinctive peeling bark. We're cruising along the muddy Pacolet now, but the morning sun still manages to reflect up onto this tree limb extending over the river. Then we stand amazed for a moment and admire the handiwork and dental work of one seriously overachieving beaver. How long did it take to do this? There's one more big hillside to scramble down and one more bridge to cross. But first, we finally catch up to one of the many little toads we've seen today. He remains statue still until we scooch him a little to make sure he's okay. If he's headed back up this hill, he's going to be busy a while. Not so busy is this damselfly, who seems to have all the time in the world to sit and watch the water go by. Another few turns on the trail and we slip into stealth mode, so we can sneak up on a little green heron. We watched him check things out for a while, and then had to laugh when he waddled away in a most entertaining fashion. The last spider we found was a grass spider. We gave him a little scooch too, then all jumped backward when he fired out of his tunnel like a rocket. We gave him a good look, shivered a bit, and got out of there quickly. We're at the end of the trail now, marked by the remnants of an old bridge. It washed away in a big flood in the 1920s, but the old support still stands. We also find a small outcrop of soapstone here, which unfortunately has been scarred with the initials and doodlings of vandals. Please don't deface these areas and report anyone else who does. A quick snack and a big gulp of water later, it's time to go. With the river leading the way, we start the hike back up the hill after our busy morning at Pacolet River Heritage Preserve.